Hey everyone, Marathon Hurdler here, back with some more Final Fantasy VIII. Last time, we explored the Lunatic Pandora, and saved Alone from Adele, and we managed to make it to the time-compressed world. And now it's time for the final confrontation with Ultimecia. So let's get right to it. Now this gate that I found is on the same island as where we found the Ragnarok. So if you just look a little bit to your left from where the Ragnarok is, you'll see this gate, and you can walk in. You don't need to walk in this gate. You can really take any gate that you want. You could go back to where we started and do that. But this is right beside the Ragnarok, so I decided to go ahead and use this instead. Now, one thing that I did off screen, and I want to quickly show this off, is I won back all the cards that I modded throughout the game. Not only that, but I actually did so after modding some of these cards a second time. So I won the selfie card, modded it, then won it back again. Same thing for Kiro's. I also modded off-screen the Bahamut card for 100 Megalixers. I carded Quetzalcoatl and Shiva so I could get Blizzagas and Thundagas respectively. I also modded, not here, but I modded some Red Fangs to get Faragas for everybody. And I modded Malboro Tentacles for Bio to give to everyone. And this isn't super important, but as I mentioned in the last episode, there are a couple of occasions where I'm going to want to use status, or not status, but elemental junction, and so I'm going to be taking advantage of that here. Also, I modded the Ifrit cards and, the Ifrit card and the Shiva card, not Shiva, the Siren card, to get status, attack, and elemental attacks. So now every person in my party, both active and inactive, have status attack, elemental attack, element defense times 4, and status defense times 4. So our setup is pretty much consistent throughout the group. Only Irving and Rinoa have unique setups based on their stats, but the other four have the exact same setup. So moving forward, what this does is it will allow me to switch up my junctions between parties pretty quickly. And the reason I want to do that is we're going to be using all 6 of our party members throughout this dungeon. And having encountered none equipped at all times will be useful, so that's why I want to do that. It doesn't really matter who you bring with you. I just like having Irving, as I've mentioned before, because, well, he can use... His limit break is more useful as a secondary form of attack, as opposed to what Cell brings. Now, let me make sure that I did my junctions correctly here, and make sure that Selfie has encountered none. Awesome. So then the first thing we want to do, beyond just screw around with the menu there, is we want to take on that Sphinx looking thing up there. And in case you didn't notice before, our powers have been sealed, so we can't use magic, we can't use abilities, we can't do any of that stuff. We can still junction magic to our stats, but that's it. And so what this means is we basically have to fight a bunch of bosses, a massive boss gauntlet, to get our abilities back one at a time. So the enemies or the bosses here start off pretty easy. Then they get slightly less easy, but they're still pretty easy. So, yeah, this is the first guy we want to take on, and let's jump right into it. So, one thing about the cards is that now that I know that you can actually win back these cards multiple times, it really changes my view of modding certain cards. There's really no reason not to mod, cards that you need for element defense, or status defense, or magic plus 60, or vitality plus 60, even, spirit plus 60. There's just really no reason not to, because you can get those cards back. And if you play the girl that I showed off last time, you can do so. Not only can you do so, but you can actually do so very quickly. And, I think she played just about a rare card just about every game, so there's really no reason not to take advantage of that. And what I've learned from reading online is that she'll play the cards in order of their rank. So for instance, if you played a level 8 card, or not played, but if you modded a level 8 card and a level 9 card and a level 10 card, she'll always play the level 8 card first, then the level 9, then the level 10. Now she won't always play them in every game, but that's the order in which she'll play them. But in my playing her, it never took her more than like 2 games to play another card, so it's really quick. You can get tons of items, tons of spells that you might be missing. I would definitely take advantage of that if you need to. Alright, so now we've got magic unlocked, so let's move forward here. Now, one thing I want to do is I think I want to take off the elemental attack junctions that I have equipped. So let's quickly do that. Because I think the next boss, I can't remember if it's this guy or if it's someone else, but I think like his weakness changes randomly, so we don't want to accidentally heal him by having something jumped into our attack there. So what we need to do is we're going to run across the chandelier, and it falls and we end up dropping to a lower room. Alright, so once we're down here, first of all I should point out that we have these little green circles. You might have noticed that the rest of my party, was standing on one. Basically, those are your switch party spots. So if you hit one, then you can switch your party members, or you can switch to the other team. And that's how we're going to be managing that here. So the next guy we want is hanging out right there. So let's talk to him, and we'll be in battle. So this guy is pretty easy. Now, what is his? Whatever I don't use, I don't like. So does it change? I can't remember if it changes or not. Well, regardless, it doesn't really matter because fighting him is pretty straightforward. So I think maybe he's weak against lightning, I think? I don't know. Anyway, just all you have to do is attack him. If you have Thunder Junction to your elemental defense, it'll heal you quite a bit when he counterattacks. And at this point, we should have defense based on my junctions. I have Meteor, Flare, Shell, and Life Junction to my elemental defense. So we're completely protected against all the three basic elements. But we also have some protection against some of the other elements as well. So we have protection against Earth and wind as well, so we should be pretty good. Unless an enemy uses Holy on us, or Bio, or Water, and even then, it's only going to be like 50% effective. And as you can see, he's dead. I haven't even remembered to Junction Selfie with Auto Haste, and it really has not mattered. Alright, so that's two down, and quite a few left to go, so let's just keep pressing forward here. This is like, I guess it's like most Final Fantasy games. No, not maybe most, but a number of Final Fantasy games where you have several bosses in the last dungeon. So like Final Fantasy 1, I know had this. Maybe Final Fantasy 2. Final Fantasy 3 definitely did. Final Fantasy 4, I don't think did. Let's go with item. Final Fantasy 5 did. Final Fantasy 6 did. Final Fantasy 7 did not, really. I mean, there was like an enemy gauntlet of sorts, but no, like, boss gauntlet. And then, yeah, so, I mean, this boss gauntlet is not completely unheard of. But once we get back upstairs, I think the room we want is to the left. Am I right? No, is this? No. Let's see. I think this was right. No, this was the way I wanted to go. Sorry about that. Because I need to get back to the main hall. That's what it is. Yeah, so at first we don't really need to switch our party members. I mean, we can do most of the stuff that we want to do early on pretty easily. So, yeah, eventually it will become more complicated, but not right now. And I think what I'm looking for is to the right here. Is there a room here or do I have to go upstairs? Yeah, I need to go upstairs first. It has been a little while since I've done this, so when I was coming back from my hiatus, I didn't actually retest the second half of the game, or I didn't test the last disc is what I didn't do. So some of this is a little bit rusty, unfortunately, but we'll get there. So now we need to head right, and then we want to head downstairs. And now this looks familiar. Okay. Now we're good. I knew I'd figure it out eventually. And we want to head into the hall there. You know what I should have unlocked? I should have unlocked Limit Break, because that would make life much easier for me. Anyway, so we see this room with a bunch of pictures. is supposed to be a puzzle, but even if you know the solution, you have to talk to all, you have to inspect all of the pictures anyway, so yeah, just go ahead and do that. We have encountered none equipped, so it doesn't really matter. All of these words are in Latin, although they give us the interpretation. Now, I'm not sure what... Oh, actually, I do remember. How we're supposed to know this, how to know what the solution to this puzzle is. But it'll become clear once we actually go upstairs. So for now, let's just look at this last picture here. I think that's all of them on this floor. Is that it? Yeah, so let's go upstairs and then we'll see the rest. Not the most exciting puzzle, unfortunately, but yeah, we'll see what we can do. Also, one thing that I'm thinking about doing is I'm actually thinking about making this episode a bit longer, just because, I mean, so many of my other episodes have been pretty long, and based on what there is to do here, I might try to condense everything besides the final boss into one episode, as opposed to splitting it up into two, because there aren't a lot of save points, and save is not exactly an ability I'm concerned about getting here, so I'm going to try my best to be efficient and like get through things as quickly as possible. But I'm thinking about making this episode a little bit longer, and then we're basically done because we only have the final boss and ending cutscene. So I'm actually thinking about finishing this in two parts, so this part and then one other part. We'll see how that goes, though. And for those of you who may eventually watch this video, let me know what you think about the longer videos, because one trade-off I'm thinking about making here is I can't record super often. I've been lucky in terms of having some extra time. I don't think I've seen this one. I've been lucky in having some extra time to record, but generally speaking, I don't have a ton of time to record. So what I've been trying to do to compensate, and to compensate for the fact that I can't do multiple episodes at once, is making the episodes that I do make a little bit longer. So that's kind of how I've been doing things. But some people don't like longer episodes. Some people want these bite-sized episodes that they kind of pick up and chew. So, you know, if that's what you prefer, let me know, and I'll consider that for, I guess, not this playthrough, because this one's kind of wrapping up, but maybe my next one. Because, yeah, I've actually have not really minded doing these longer episodes. I thought it would be a problem, but, you know, with the editing process for me, while not particularly long, is long enough to where, you know, it adds enough time to where, given my limited schedule, it can prevent me from recording stuff that I want to record. But anyway, the way we're supposed to know how to solve this puzzle is by looking at the clock. You have number 8, you have 6, and then you have 4 there. And I think what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to look for pictures that have those letters in them. So we want to find one with like the, what is it? What are the numbers again? So you have one with like VIII. You want to find one with VI and then one with III. Or not I, wait. Shouldn't that be an IV? Well, nonetheless, you want to find the one with like the 4 eyes in it. Kind of, yeah, I'm pretty sure that should be, if we're doing this correctly, that should be IV, but don't let that get in the way of a good puzzle, right? So, before we go and inspect this big picture, though, I'm actually going to remember to junction auto haste to selfie, and then I'm also going to junction tornado to my elemental attack, because I'm pretty sure this guy is weak to wind. Hopefully he is, because if not, I'm going to feel pretty stupid. Let's see. Put a squall. Put tornado on his elemental attack. And then same thing for Irving. Because we can't use limit breaks yet. So we want to do everything we can to increase our damage output. Alright, so looking at these words, we want to pick the one with... It's too fake to read. Oh, okay, yeah. So we want to pick the one with the B, III, which is the BB Darium. Then we want to pick the one with the 4 eyes in it, which is this one, Intervigilium, whatever that is. And then we want to pick the one with just the... Okay, so now we want to pick the one with just the IV, with the IV. So I think I was right. Anyway. In the garden sleeps a messenger. Yeah, so that's... That is correct. See, I think I'm just may have seen that number incorrectly or something. Nonetheless, once you solve the puzzle, the next boss in our boss count list shows up. So let's take him on. And this is Trauma. Now, you might recognize most of these bosses for being on the level 7 boss cards. And I guess it's only appropriate that those would be bosses at the end of the game. So, yeah, pretty cool there. This guy, not much tougher than everyone else we fought to this point. Just lay on him with your physical attacks. I do think he is weak to wind, because it seems like we're doing slightly more damage than we would otherwise. His defense is actually pretty high, and I'm not using Vitality or Meltdown on him, so I'm making things probably a little bit harder on myself than I need to. But not by much. So I think at this point he's going to release some of his... Nope. Oh yeah. So he has these little... I can't remember what they're called, but he can like create these little helpers to go with him. Not like it really is really going to help him that much, because he's pretty much dead, or he's pretty close to being dead. But he can drain health from his little toy soldier there. And it looks like it's a counterattack then. So I guess once he gets down to low health, maybe he starts using that as a permanent counterattack. But yeah, they're called Dromas. But as you can see, they're pathetically weak. As most enemies are at this point in the game. You know, at some point, maybe... Oh yeah, he killed off his little Droma. I guess he's going to have to create another one if he wants to drain from them, but he won't get the chance because he's dead. Alright, simple enough. So now, that's three down, and we have quite a bit more to do here, so... We did get an elemental attack, so if you needed one, there you go. That actually might have... I may not have needed to refine the Ifrit card for the elemental attack then, but whatever, not like it really matters. So let's see, Selfie, go back to encounter none, want to avoid as many enemies as possible here. So from here, now we want to head north, and then we're going to be looking for our next enemy to fight. Still not going to switch parties. Let's see. Then I want to go up the stairs? No, I want to go down the stairs. And then... Yeah, we should be pretty good to go here. What we're looking for... And then I want to take this path, I believe. Yeah, this is the path I want to take. I'm pretty sure. Yep, perfect. So this is what we want right there. The door closes to get out. We need the key. But when we do that, then an enemy is going to pop up. So let's go ahead and give Selfie auto haste again. And make sure everyone has the magic ability equipped so we can use Meltdown on our next boss. Awesome, got the prison key. And then, there you go. He doesn't look too happy. I mean, this was kind of a trap, but whatever. So this is the Red Giant. Similar to the Iron Giant, but with much more defense. However, he's easily defeated with a little trick. So we're going to use Meltdown to get rid of his defense. Then we're going to use Aura on Irving to basically wipe him out. It shouldn't take very long at all to deal with him. Now, the other way you can do this, if you don't have Meltdown, is you can always use... Demi on him, because he's actually one of the few boss enemies who are weak to Demi, but nah, I don't feel like doing that. That takes too long. So, yeah, we're just going to rip him apart with Shot. Not bad, Irby, not bad. And he's dead. So, yeah, much faster than trying to use Demi. Although, if you use Demi on him, he actually, like, freaks out and he's like, I don't like demis, please stop. And then if you attack him with a physical attack without using meltdown, he kind of laughs at you and is like, oh, physical attacks won't do anything to me. But that's a much faster way of doing it. So, like I said, you can't beat the meltdown slash limit break spam technique. And I think that's it in the prison. Let's see. Now, what do I want to unlock? I'll unlock command ability, sure. Now, let's see. I want to go back to the main room, I think. Yeah, so we use the prison key to leave, and I think I actually want to head back to the main hall, and then we'll progress from there. So, yeah, this is moving along pretty fast. I think we're about halfway through with the boss enemies. I can't remember if we are or not, but I think what we want to do here is we want to switch here. So when I said head back to the main hall, I meant actually head back in that direction. Do I want to switch parties here? I don't want to just stop here. I actually want to go all the way back to the main hall. That's right. The next guy is... I remember where the next guy is now, so... We actually need both parties to be in the main room. Although, we're not actually going to fight with the other party. So, let's see. Head upstairs, and then head to the left. So, the reason we need to do this is... We need our other party to make sure that chandelier that was falling before doesn't fall. So, we have to find a way to keep that up in the air. So, let's... Can I get up the stairs? There we go. Alright, so... Head down. And then we want to head to the green circle and we'll switch over to our other party. So let's see here. Get in the circle. Switch to the yellow party. Now I'm going to do a junction exchange with Zell and Selfie, just so I don't run into any encounters on the way there. So... Let's see, switch, and then, Zell, and Selfie. There we go. We should be good now. So what we want to do is head back to that room where the chandelier fell down. Oh, wait, how did I run into an enemy? I must have forgotten... Oh, I know what I did. I forgot to, I put auto haste on, and I just completely forgot to take it off. Wait a minute. Yeah, that's what I did. That was stupid of me. Well, we'll fix that shortly. Yeah, these guys died pretty quickly. The interesting thing about this area is the enemies here can be really any level. Their level varies widely and doesn't seem to be based on what your actual level is. The same is true of the bosses here. Their level doesn't seem to matter. It doesn't seem to be based on... what your level is. And I think for some of these enemies, the maximum level they have is like in the 50s. So they can't even be at level 100. So, yeah. And those enemies were clearly, even for our levels, they were clearly not at level 100. Because I think the Mesmer, whatever his name is, has more HP than it was letting on there. Alright, so now we want to head over to the green circle here. And then we want to lower the level. There's a lever over here that we want to lower. Let's see. Is it here? I thought it was right here. Nope. Hold on. Is this not it? I'm pretty sure this was the room. There we go. Took a while. I was getting worried there for a second. But now we want to switch over to our other party. And... Once again, I'll switch my junctions to make sure everything is set. And then we will continue on. So, Selfie and Zell. And now, we're going to be able to walk across the balcony there without any problem, which is a good thing. And then, we'll be finding our next boss. So, yeah, the boss gauntlet moves on unimpeded. I'm pretty sure it's right over here. Yep, there we go. That's a creepy looking guy. But this is Krista, yet another one of the boss cards that you can get. I think all the boss enemies here represent or on boss cards of some sort. Anyway. Yeah, you say that now, and again, I forgot to... Shoot. I forgot to, what did I do? I forgot to give Selfie auto-haste. Not like it really matters, but... Same strategy as before. Meltdown. Irving. Let me make sure he has 100, yeah. Then Aura on Irving, and then we'll take him out pretty quickly that way. Now, does he have a counterattack? Yep, he does. And it's pitiful. Wait, did another arm just come out of his, like, stomach there? That's weird. Anyway, let's use our AP ammo again to take him out. Now, I wonder if he can survive one full turn of shot. Oh, that's going way too slow. He has no chance. Yeah, he had no chance there. Sorry, buddy. But he does use Ultima as a... Oh, yeah, he uses Ultima as a final attack, so... I shouldn't pretend like I knew that ahead of time. I completely forgot until he did it, so... Yeah. And it did 100 damage to each of us. The power of maximum defense. Like, I mean, it's pretty easy to get maximum strength and HP, and I think most people do that. But they really underrate the value of having maximum vitality and spirit. It just negates so many enemies, because so few enemies have really high strength and magic. So... Anyway, that's basically it. So, now what I think we want to do is we need to go, we actually need to run back to where our other party is. So we need to go down to that second that room where the chandelier is, but on the bottom floor. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run there off screen just to try to save a little bit of time at this point, because I've already shown you how to get there. And I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Now, I think what we want to do here is we want to go through those doors up at the top. And... Because I don't think we can get back upstairs because those stairs are broken. And, yeah, so this is where we want to go. And now we're at the Fountain Square. Remember this for later. We'll be coming back here. Now we want to go through... the doors right up to the front, and once we're here, then we want to go up a set of stairs. Now notice this little weird miasma type of thing, because we'll be dealing with that eventually. Now let's see, once we get upstairs, I think we just cross the bridge, so we want to hold that triangle. We want to walk, not run, across the bridge, so hold circle, and then we can grab the armory key there. And now we're going to go all the way back to the main hall, so, yeah, I'll meet you back at the main hall. Alright, I'm back. So now what we want to do, now that we're here, I think we want to... head back the way we came, so I keep trying to run through the door on the bottom level when we actually need to head to the second level. So basically where we're going to go is we're going to go back to where we fought that red giant earlier. But instead of going into the prison, we're going to want to go in a different direction. Now one thing to mention about that armory key is that if you ran across the bridge... it would fall off of the bridge and down to the ground. But even then, you're not screwed because you can basically pick it up on your way to our next destination. So now that we're in this room, I think what we're looking for is... Let's see. I think it's the door on the... No. We need to... Not here. We actually need to go one more down. Because the room is on the right. So, we want to head down here. And... Yeah. This room we can unlock. Now, if you... Like I said before, if you drop the key then it would be like right here, so no worries either way. But before I go in there, I'm going to give Selfie auto haste again. And I think that's basically it. I mean, one thing you could consider doing, if you are interested, you might want to give yourself some zombie spells if you want an instant kill on this guy, but I'm not worried about that. And so, we're going to be fighting Gargantua. Now, what makes Gargantua interesting, well, maybe not interesting, is that he actually starts off as a standard enemy. And this enemy, who I haven't shown up before, is called Visage. He has three components to him. Righty, lefty, and his main body. And I don't know if you need to kill them separately, or like, if you kill the Visage, you kill them all. And like, I mean, he is countering with Meteor, but like, I mean, look at that damage. Although I will give him props, he's doing more damage than Fujin was doing. Barely. But yeah, I don't know if you need to... I don't know if it's one of those cases where if you kill the Visage, like, the Righty and Lefty go with them. Nope, it isn't. Alright. I thought if I killed the head, we'd all be good, but nope. And now that he's casting Meteor again, I'm kind of wishing I would have killed him the right hand... Or the, that Righty or Lefty? Yeah, it would be Lefty, I guess. I'm wishing I would have killed Lefty right off the bat. Whatever. It's fine. So we're... This is not... Yeah, these guys aren't serious. Like... I mean, you can kind of see how quickly we're killing them here. So now what we want to do is get ready to use our... Oops, he's not dead yet. Let's go ahead and shoot him. There you go. Nope, he's still not dead? Really? I mean, I was trying to get set up for the guy who comes after this. Because that's not the boss. The actual boss is the one who shows up right now. It's like the Super Visage. Yeah. Now what makes this guy interesting is that he actually, beyond the fact that he starts off with like the fake boss battle, is that he actually casts What makes him interesting is that he will counter any attack you use against him with a pretty powerful counterattack called Counter Twist. Now, I'm not sure if it's just magic or if it's physical attacks. It looks like it's just physical attacks. Or maybe it's not a guaranteed counter. At any rate, it's pretty powerful, but it doesn't particularly matter because you can just wipe him out with your limit breaks pretty easily nonetheless. I mean, seriously, it takes one of Irving's limit breaks to take them out. I'm sure this looks really uninteresting to see me, like, killing all of these bosses this way. I promise I'm not trying to bore you, but this is really the easiest way to do that. Alright, so what do we have going on here? Next up, we need to head back to the... Now we need to head back to the main hall. And in fact, we need to go past the main hall back to the fountain room. So remember, you go to the chandelier room. Then once you get to the chandelier room, you just run past that to get to the... Run north past that to the fountain room. So what I'm going to do is I think I'm just going to meet you there.
Okay, I'm back. Now what I need to do here is I need to check apparently the left side of the fountain to find the treasure vault key. So it should be somewhere around here. If I can't find it, then I might just take a quick pause break and then come back. Oh, nope, we got it. Perfect. So now, and this is the fun of this dungeon, we have to head all the way back to the main hall. And then, yeah, that's basically what we have to do. So, I'm going to meet you back at the main hall, in front of those stairs. Okay, I'm back. What I want to do now is I'm actually going to switch my party. And this is good because I was going to do this anyway for the ultimate boss that we're going to be fighting. So, let's switch Zell
and Selfie. So we have all the ladies in one party, all the guys in one party. Those three, the guys, are my most powerful attackers with their limit breaks. And then the ladies are, well, they can handle themselves. So, let's see. Now I want to continue to head north and continue to push past this area into the next room. And I believe if I did this right, this should be a room with elevators. Did I do it right? Yes, there's an elevator right there. So, let's switch to the other party. Now with this party, I have to go all the way back to the main hall again, and through, no, I don't want to switch parties, and through the art gallery that where we fought Trauma. But since we're already pretty close to the main hall, oh. Okay, so I'm at the art gallery. I was going to show off me running there, but once I ran into that battle, I figured, why bother? Alright, so what we need to do, go through the art gallery, and now what we want to do is go through this room to the left. And now we will be also, or not yet, but once we go across here, if I do this right, hold on, am I doing this right? Let's see. There we go. I thought I was doing this correctly. And there's a save point in case you need it. But I do not. Now this should be the elevator room. Perfect. So now we get on the elevator. And the elevator is going to rise up for us. Awesome. And now we want to switch to the other party. And then... let's see. Now I want to switch my junctions. I don't want to screw this up again, so I think Zell had it, so I'll give it to Selfie. And then, once I've switched parties, then I want to go left of here. And the floodgate, yep, there's the key right there. Once I grab the floodgate key, I want to go back over. And... we're going to switch parties again. So now what I want to do is head back to the area where I fought the Red Giant and Gargantua. So if you remember, that's the room past the art gallery. So I almost forgot there. So I need to switch my junctions again. But now what I want to do is head back to that room where I fought the Red Giant and the... what's his name? Gargantua. So, I'll meet you there. Okay, I'm back. So now what I want to do is hit that lever right there beside... if I can get it. Let's see. Hold on. Is this the right lever? Yeah, this is the right lever. I just gotta see if I can get it to... there we go. Do I need to inspect it again? There we go. Perfect. So now, what we need to do, more backtracking, head all the way back to the fountain room, which is past the chandelier room, so I'll meet you there. Okay, I'm back. Now what we want to do, well, I'm going to show you what we're trying to get, and then I will show you how we're going to do it, and if I can't do it, then I'll do it off screen. So what we're looking for is... down here, if I can get it to work. I think it is anyway. Oh yeah, no, it's right here. See how these spikes are up? We want to get those spikes down. And the way we're going to do that is not really via a mini game, but we have to go back to the organ room. So basically what we need to do here is we need to hit all of the buttons in the organ room to make this work. So unfortunately I don't, as I've mentioned before, with the Elgato, I can't really listen to the game sound without it screwing up. So, if for some reason this is going to sound terrible, but if for some reason this doesn't work, then I'm just going to finish doing it off screen so I can, like, mute my sound and actually listen to the game. Alright. So, hoping that did the trick. You have to push all of the buttons. So R1, L1, R2, L2, circle, triangle, square, and X. If I did it right, then all the spikes will be downed. If I did not do it correctly, then there will be some spikes left, in which case I will probably pause here. Yeah, you can see there are some spikes still up, so I can't get through. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish doing this off screen, and then I'll meet you back here once I actually do it correctly. I'll spare your ears the trouble there. Okay, finally got it. It took multiple attempts, and my ears are now bleeding. But anyway, the reward that we get, as I've already mentioned, we run down the hall, all the way to the right, and there will be a box waiting for us with the final Rosetta Stone in the game. So, with that equipped, or that, we can finally adjust our junctions so that everyone will have ability times 4. So, by the time we start the next battle, or the final battle of the game, we'll be good to go. So, not going to do that right now because this recording is getting a little bit long, even though I will be editing a lot of this out, and I want to make sure I get through everything I need to get through, so I'll show that off next time. But today, we want to continue along with this dungeon here. So what I want to do now is head up the stairs here to the right. And yeah, we're basically just going to climb these stairs that's not what I wanted to do. We're going to cross the bridge, then we're going to be climbing a bunch of stairs to get to the last of the bosses to unseal our abilities. I mean, at this point, we only have one left, and I've only been using the same ability for, like, the entire dungeon, but, you know, it's there, I guess. And then all we have left is one optional super boss, and we're basically done with this dungeon, and we're almost done with our journey in Final Fantasy VIII, which, it'll be nice when it's all said and done, when I can finally say that I finished one playthrough, but we're not quite there yet. We still have some work to do. Now, I will say I do like this dungeon. I know that I'm complaining a little bit about it. I do really like the dungeon and the idea behind it. Some of the tracking I could have done without, but, you know, beyond that, it's still pretty good. Nope, I need to go a little bit higher. What we want to do is we want to jump on that bell there. Let's see. Am I high enough now? Perfect. Jump on the bell, and then they'll jump off, and our next boss will be awaiting for us across the hall there. Now, do I still have time? Yep, I can still adjust my junction. So, let's go ahead and give Zell auto haste, as we normally do, so. Alright, let's get to it. And so, this is basically a Bahamut clone. And he sneaks up on us. You could equip initiative or like alert to avoid this. I think it's a back attack. But nope, it's not. Alright. So basically this guy, all he's going to do is he's just going to try to set up his ultimate attack, Dark Flare. And once it's spelled across the screen, you're basically screwed. But not really, because it's an elemental attack and we're protected against the elements that it uses. So we're actually going to be in perfectly fine shape. But beyond that, strategy remains the same. Set up Irving for his limit break, and I screwed it up there. So let's have them attack, so I can just have him focus on trying to get his limit break. There we go. AP ammo. Now, I must have equipped... What, though? Why am I doing 0 damage? That doesn't seem right. Am I missing something here? I must have junctioned something to his elemental... their elemental attacks that I forgot to take off. Oh, that's what it is. I have Tornado equipped to my elemental attack. I completely forgot about that. Shoot. Well, luckily my shot attack is non-elemental. Otherwise, I'd be in real trouble, wouldn't I? Jeez. And we killed him. That would have been really unfortunate if I screwed that one up. This is why I generally do not use elemental attack, because I always forget to take it off later. I'm just really lucky it didn't kick me in the butt here. But, yeah. One other thing I should point out before I forget is that with all of these bosses, they carry some of the GFs that you could have picked up throughout the game in case you missed them. So, for instance, you could pick up Eden right now if you never fought the Ultima weapon. I mean, obviously, I wanted to show that off, but some people don't want to fight him because they want to keep the fixed encounters. So, there you go. But now we have the last ability. We have the last ability unlocked. So we could take on Ultimecia, but I'm not going to. Instead, I'm going to try to take on the ultimate super boss in the game, the Omega Weapon. To do that, we're going to need to equip Encounter None, and we're going to need to head back to the area outside of the chapel. So I'm going to meet you there. Alright, so I'm back. Now this is where we're going to want to stand, or we're going to want to switch party members here. But first, I want to show off a few things that I'm going to do here. First, I'm going to call any generic shop, buy some Phoenix Downs, just in case, because someone's likely going to die throughout the battle. I'm actually going to buy a couple more. I have all the Mega Elixirs that I've refined from, what's it called? From Bahamas card, and I'm just going to quickly heal up. Just to make sure we're in good shape there. Perfect. And now we're going to switch to our other party. So what we need to do with the other party is go back to that room where the, the room right before the gallery. So what I'm going to do then is, first I'm going to make sure I have Encounter None. Did I not switch my junction there? I thought I did. No, I must not have. So let's switch my junction then. So I'll take Zell and switch with Selfie. Let's see if that does it. Do you have... There we go. Encounter now. Perfect. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to meet you in that room. It's like it's up the stairs in the main hall to the right. Okay, I'm back. Now, for this to work, you're going to need some Cracker Jack timing. We're going to need to adjust our setup before we do this. So what's going to happen is we're going to pull this bell, then that's going to start a timer. We're going to need to switch back to Zell and the crew over there, and then we need to track down and kill Omega Weapon. But we're going to need to keep Encounter None on, because we can run into enemies, in which case the timer continues, but is obviously going to just run out before we get to him. So we're going to need to use that until we get to where he is, then switch auto haste on. So I'm going to quickly make some adjustments to my setup on screen. First things first, I'm going to do a quick switch between Selfie and Zell so that he has Encounter None. Next, we need to make sure we have all the important abilities set up. So that means taking off a couple of our GFs here for that purpose. Don't worry, I will adjust the setup again later. So Leviathan, we're going to want Recover. What do you have? Nothing here I'm concerned with. What about you? Ifrit, Siren, and Bahamut. Nope. Nothing there I'm concerned with. So really, I just could use Leviathan. And even then, it's not... Wait, actually... Did one of them have brothers? Yeah, you had brothers. I definitely want brothers. Sorry, Kesis, your junctions are all screwed up. Now let's see. I'll give you brothers. Right. And then what I want to give him is defend for his last ability. We're not going to be drawing anything. The Omega Weapon has Ultima, but we're not concerned with that ability. So then I'm also going to give you defend. We don't need draw for you. And then, let's see. I'll give Squall recover. So instead of GF, item. No, actually, let's leave you with... No, let's give you recover. You never know when you might need that. I mean, I could end up regretting this, but I think I'll be fine, because I have the Phoenix Downs. So let's go with, instead of draw for you, we'll give you recover, and then you're good to go. Everything else stays the same. You want max stats, obviously. Elemental defense, you don't need to worry about that. You do want death for your status defense, so you absolutely need that, or else you just won't survive, so... Alright, I think that's everything. You know what, actually, let's let's give him revive. I actually feel more comfortable with revive than with recover there. So let's do that. And then I think we should be good to go. So let's do it. If I can figure out how to pull the switch here. Should be right here. There you go. Now hopefully I don't run into an enemy on the way to the green circle there. If I screw this up, then, well, I'll come back and show you. I'll show you when I do this successfully, basically. So get into the green circle. There we go. Switch to the other party. Now, once we get into the room where Omega is, he's in the chapel. Once we get there, then I'll go ahead and switch Zell to encounter to auto haste, not encounter none. All right, now you can see the Omega weapon sitting there. So let's switch our junction ability real quick. Give him auto haste. We should still have time. Good, 19 seconds. That should be plenty of time. No enemies. All right, we got him. So now we are taking on the Omega weapon. Everything else doesn't matter. All you want is to give you... Yeah, the setup we have will be sufficient. So first things first, we want to get Meltdown on Omega. The second thing we want to do, get Aura on... Where is it? Aura. Aura on Irving. We're going to want to have as many people as possible using... their limit breaks, but the first priority is just keeping everyone alive. So Zell is going to be primarily on standby to make sure people are as healthy as possible. So yeah, we're going to use shot there, AP ammo, then we're going to use Cura on Squall, and then have Zell use Aura on Squall as well to make sure we're good to go. Now it might seem like I'm being a bit OCD about keeping them at full health, but that's not the case. So what the Omega weapon has is he has an ability called Medigo Flame, and what that does is it inflicts 9,998 damage on all of your party members and is completely unavoidable. So basically, if you don't have maximum health, you will die. So yeah, that's why I'm keeping his HP high. Now what I want to do here, do I have a Mega Potion? I'm going to have Zell use a Mega Potion. Again, we're going to want to keep our health at maximum. The other thing I should point out is there's a fixed order in his attacks. Now occasionally he will mix in a physical attack between this order, but the order outside of that in terms of his special abilities is always the same. He always starts with level 5 death. That's just unavoidable. He always uses level 5 death to begin with. So if you don't have death junction to your status defense, or unless you're like at level 99 or something, you will die. From there, he does Meteor, which we just saw, which is an indication that he's going to use Medigo Flame next. Then he uses Graviha. After Graviha, he uses another attack called Terra Break, which will annihilate your party as well, which is why we have Defend. So, shoot. Let's get Zell using a Mega Elixir, because we're going to be down to 1 health. Alright. And then get our Limit Breaks going. So next is going to be Graviha. After Graviha, we're going to want to use Defend for Zell and Irving in there, so that they don't die. Come on. Perfect. Please use Lionheart. Nope, no Lionheart. Alright. Thought I was going to get lucky there. Not today. But we are getting a long, long go with this AP ammo. Perfect. So, that's a good bit of damage right there. That's why I really enjoy using his limit breaks as opposed to using... You know what? I shouldn't... Wait. What? So, I guess I'll be able to show off how this works at least. So, Gilgamesh is different from Odin in the sense that he doesn't show up at the beginning of battle. He will just randomly show up in the middle of a battle. And he'll use one of 4 attacks. So let's see which one he uses. So he tries to use Zantatuken here, but he's not susceptible to instant death attacks. So that doesn't really help us that much, unfortunately. But yeah, so that's the downside of Gilgamesh is that he'll show up even when you can't even kill an enemy via instant death attacks. But he can use other attacks. I can't remember what they're all called. I think there's like Excalibur. There's also Excalibur. Excalibur does like 1 point of damage regardless. So yeah, let's have them defend. Zell and Irving defend. And we'll have Squall use... I really almost screwed that up. We'll have Squall use his Renzokuken as long as he can until Omega Weapon uses his... Until Omega Weapon uses his Terra Break, which will almost assuredly kill Squall. And what Defend does, and I don't think I've mentioned this before, is it basically prevents you from taking any damage as long as you don't input another command. Which is nice. I mean, obviously you can't do anything while you're in Defend, but in this one limited case, it's actually really nice. I don't know if you could use that to defend against Medigo Flame. I'm sure you probably could. I don't know, I just never really thought about doing that. Anyway. So yeah, we're going to use Defend for Irving and Squall. Not Irving and Squall. Irving and Zell. And we're just not going to use their turns until we... Yeah, so now you see where he's doing the... he's using his Terra Break ability, which is going to annihilate Squall more than likely, but Zell and Irving will remain alive. So it does, like, as you can see, it does, like, 14 hits. I mean, it will literally annihilate your party if you do not have, if you don't have defend. I mean, even if you have, like, max stats, it just does way too much damage for you to be able to survive. So, just don't even try to mess with that. And there must be another way to survive it. I think what other people do, which I try not to here, is they use, they'll use heroes or like holy wars to prevent, to make, basically make them immune. So that's one way of handling it, but if you don't want to do that, then you're basically stuck with defend. And I think having protect helps a little bit, but even then, the hits will do 2,000 points of damage per hit, so it's like, that's not really helping you that much. Is he dead yet? Nope. Can I get a lemon break going here? Anyone? There we go. AP ammo. Come on, Renzokuken. Damn it. There we go. And now he's going to use Ultima, which shouldn't do that much damage to us, given our high spirit. Let's see. Yeah, that barely did anything. But up next is Light Pillar, an attack that Ultima Weapon also has, which we never got to see, which does 9,999 damage to us, so that's an automatic kill anyway. So I'm going to let him use that. And then once he does that and uses Meteor, that's when I'll use my next like Mega Potion or Mega Elixir or whatever. Can I get another one? Oh shoot, I screwed that up. Let me break. Nope, I already lost my aura. Come on. As you can see, he's really, really fast. I mean, it's ridiculous. Come on. Renzokuken, there we go. And then we're going to use aura on Irving, of course. So this is basically our mode of attack. You could use aura on Zell as well, and I brought him along because of the remaining four characters, he has the next best limit break in terms of damage. But again, I choose not to because it's just not worth it. You don't really get anything for it. So yeah, as you can see, Squall gets killed by the Light Pillar, does max damage, nothing we can do about that. So let's just keep going with what we've got here. So we'll use a Phoenix Down on Squall. We'll probably need to use at least some sort of potion on him just to make... I think we'll be fine. We'll wait till he uses Meteor then before we... Come on. Darn it. There we go. AP ammo. Let's have Zell use a Mega Elixir on us so that we're at full health. And then we'll get Squall's Renzokuken going as well. Now the Omega Weapon has a ton of HP, as you can tell. We have been just annihilating him with attacks and he just won't go down. So I think his health is like over a million. Yeah, I mean it's really, really high. You're going to be going at him for a while. Especially at level 100, or I guess he's always at level 100. I'm pretty sure in the PlayStation version, he's always at level 100. I've heard that in the PC version, he can be at any other level, so like he can be at a level based on whatever your level is, but I think in the PlayStation version, he's always at level 100. I mean, whenever I've come to fight him, I've always been at level 100, so I wouldn't know, but I'm pretty sure that's the case. And this is a new finisher I don't think we've seen, because I haven't really... because we've been stuck with his basic weapon for so long. It's called Blasting Zone, and what it does is it attacks all enemies, but it's only one hit, so it's basically just Rough Divide in this case. And I think he has another attack called Faded Circle, which basically comes down to the same thing. Alright, another Mega Elixir. There we go. And yeah, he's gonna do max damage to us, or close to it. And then we get both of our limit breaks going. Now I'm hoping that this will be the last round before we have him finished. This is gonna be a long episode, but hopefully we've got him finished so then we can finally move on to the end. It'd be great if we got a Lionheart. Nope. Well, I guess we're going to see all five of, or not all five, but all four of his finishers. So we saw Rough Divide to begin, then we went on to Lionheart. Faded Circle is the second one you can get, and then you have, what was it, the Blasting Zone. The middle two are attack all but one hit. Then you also have Lionheart, which is clearly the best, which does a ton of damage to a single target. He is still kicking, huh? Wow. Still kicking. I am impressed, sir. I am impressed. So let's get Aura on Squall there. Have Irving cast Aura on himself. Although I guess it doesn't really matter because he's going to cast Rabiha soon anyway. So Irving won't really be able to do much. Nonetheless, let's get it going with Squall and his Limit Break. That's it? You're not even going to do your heavy combo there, buddy? Alright, I guess. I would appreciate it if you would do a little more for me there. Come on, someone give me a Limit Break. I'm going to risk it. I'm going to risk it here. I acknowledge that this is dangerous and I could end up really costing myself. But I got all my turns in before he finishes attack, so there's no way he should be able to get Terra Break on us before we get Defend up. Come on, Squall. Give me a Lionheart. Finish him off. Don't make my risk look... or you could give me a Rough Divide. Sure, why not? I'm hoping this risk doesn't end up biting me in the butt. It looks like it could bite me in the butt. Shoot. Alright, let's get another Defend then. You gotta defend, buddy. Alright, Renzokuken and defend. Come on, give me a Lionheart. One time. Oh, and now I'm just missing all my triggers. Getting so caught up trying to get Lionheart that I'm just messing up the damage I could be getting, guaranteed. Come on. Please finish him off. I'd really like it if you finished him off. I mean, this is only going to be one hit, so I don't feel that confident about this, but who knows. Oh, wow, we got him. Whew. I was worried there. I mean, we already had Terra Break up. I mean, Defend up, so we were going to be fine, but still. I was a little bit nervous. So, that's the final test for us. That's the test of our ultimate powers. I mean, as you can see, the defense really helped. I mean, his physical attacks and magic attacks didn't do much to us. It's just the attacks that were going to be deadly regardless that we were kind of screwed with. But, alright, we took on Omega, and for defeating him, we get another 3 stars. Not that great, considering how tough he is. I have come around on the 3 stars, but given how tough he is, you can't say that was really worth it. Anyway, you also get the proof of Omega, and I think they might have just put that into our inventory there. Wait, what? Where is it? You're supposed to get another item for killing him. Where is it? It's called the Proof of Omega. I can't seem to find it. Maybe it's on the ground or something. So let's give Zell Encounter None, and then we'll see if we can track this down. Because we're supposed to get... Oh no, it's in the tutorial, isn't it? Is it under information or something? There it is, Proof of Omega. Yeah, okay, that's the award you get for beating Omega there. So, not that great, but we're finally ready to head on to the end of the game. Once and for all, we're finally ready to take on Ultimecia. So to do that, we need to head back towards Tiamat, Tiamat, I think it's how it's pronounced. And then we're going to head all the way up the stairs, but instead of taking the bell there, we're just going to continue to climb. So, what do I want to do here? So, I'm going to go ahead and explain what I'm going to do off screen, because it's going to take me a while to get up here anyway, and that way, once I get to the save point, I can just be done for the episode. But off screen, I'm going to put my setup back to where it started. I'm going to give the Rosetta Stone to whoever has ability, who doesn't have ability times 4. I think it's Selfie. I'll put together my final setup, and then that will basically be it. And then I'll show it off at the beginning of the next episode, and then we'll take on Ultimecia and move from there. So that's what I'm going to do off screen, so that I can save some time in between episodes here. And I think that's just about it. I mean, there's another draw point there, which is worthless, and we're going to get to walk around on some cool stuff, I guess. I mean, we can walk over across the clock there, and then we climb on this ladder. But I mean, in terms of like actual gameplay, that's basically it. I mean, there's no more boss fights, there's no more treasure, no more side quests, no more cards to pick up, no more spells to draw. I mean, there's really nothing to do at this point besides take on Ultimecia, and you can see the save point up there. I'll go ahead and run to the end, but this is basically it, guys. We are finally at the end of the game, and next episode, you'll get to see my characters with completely maxed out stats across the board, and we'll take on Ultimecia and show her our true power. But until then, this has been Marathon Hurtler. I want to thank you as always for checking out my videos, and hopefully I will see you next time.